In this lesson, we'll be discussing the structural formulas of amino acids. The question reads, draw the zwitterion for each of the following amino acids, serine, aspartate, and leucine. Let's take a look at the general formula of an amino acid. All amino acids have this carboxyl group, which I'm hovering over, and this amino group. What differentiates the different types is this part, which we abbreviate with R for the rest of the molecule. Now at physiological pH, amino acids change a little bit. In fact, you end up forming this ammonium group where you have a charged nitrogen, and the carboxyl group becomes a carboxylate where it loses that hydrogen. In this particular case, the R group is CH3, which is called alanine. Now you'll notice that the ionized ammonium and the carboxylate groups gives the amino acid a balance of positive and negative charge, which is overall zero. Neutral amino acids are called zwitterions, and they occur at a specific pH value known as the isoelectric point. That being said, let's begin with the first example, A, serine. Serine looks like this. This is the amino group, this is the carboxyl group, and that's the R group. In a solution, you should expect the carboxyl group to lose its hydrogen over to the amino part, making it negative and the amino group positive. This leaves the ionic form of the amino acid net neutral. So this should become NH3+, and that should lose its hydrogen and become the carboxylate. That's the answer to question A. Let's move on to B. Here's a visual representation of aspartic acid. Aspartate is the ionic version of that amino acid. And just like before, in order for this to be neutral, there will be a transfer of this hydrogen over to this nitrogen, making this positive and this negative. And for curiosity's sake, it turns out that the neutral form of aspartic acid forming aspartate occurs at a pH of 2.77. So that would be considered the isoelectric point for this amino acid. Finally, in question C, we have to do this again for a leucine. Leucine looks like this. That's the structure, and we'll lose this hydrogen. We'll form a bond with the nitrogen, making that positive, this negative, and notice that the R group here is nonpolar, unlike, for example, in serine, where we had this hydroxyl at the very end, or this carboxyl group in aspartate. So there you have it, a quick introduction to zwitterions and the structural formulas of amino acids.